Well, second marriages can mean a new lease on life for the parties involved, but there can be some financial complications as well. Senior financial planner Alex Manassas with Zarka Financial. He joins us this morning to share some of the money mistakes people make the second time around. And there can be a lot of complications with this if you have, you know, child support. So, and do a lot of people sometimes get surprised when they have that second marriage?
Yes. The most important thing to remember is there's a lot of things you really need to talk about when it comes to finances, because otherwise financial issues can torpedo any marriage, especially second marriages. There's special things to keep in mind.
Mm-hmm. I mean, there's a lot of things too, like, I mean, child support, alimony and stuff like that. These are little things that can sometimes come in and where you might think the one spouse is making a great living, but there's a drain on that, and, you know, it drains in the second marriage.
That's right. One of the things people are kind of hesitant to talk about is their debts. And if you're looking to get together with somebody, especially get legally married, it's important to understand what debts they might have. For example, there are articles out, you know, saying that younger people, when they evaluate the fitness of a marriage partner, they look at their student loans.
Okay.
They're wondering, you know, does this person have a lot of student loans that I'm going to have to take over or help with? So, for example, you might think your spouse has a great income, but then they actually have, you know, alimony, they have child support from previous marriages, they might have credit card debt, and that could be a rude surprise once you get married that you didn't know about before.
Mm-hmm. Now, hopefully the second time will be the enduring marriage, so you have to think about retirement as well, too, that you may have, that's a discussion that needs to come in there as well.
Yes, here's a big one, okay? If something happens to you, where should your assets go? One spouse might be thinking, my assets are going to go to my children. Mm-hmm. The other one might be thinking, no, it's going to go to them. So you need to talk about that, how to take care of everybody. Also, update your will, your powers of attorney, your life insurance designations, your IRA beneficiary designations, all of that. Imagine if you pass away and you forgot to update those and you
right.
left a previous spouse named as beneficiary.
And see, and that can also cause a lot of problems too, but like for many people too, in order to, that should be the discussion that they should sit down and talk together, but also with a financial planner to try to balance what they need here.
Yes, I see this in my office all the time. You'd be surprised. People come into my office and the clients have never really discussed these issues. And part of my job is to bring it up and ask them how they feel about it. And a lot of times these discussions are held almost exclusively just in the financial planner's office. So I'm a little bit like therapy, if you can believe that.
So love and money don't always mix.
Not always.
Not always. Well, should they merge bank accounts? Should that be something they should come right at?
Well, that's a really good one. Another thing people should talk about in advance is how much should each one contribute to joint living expenses? Should it be based on proportionate to your income, or should it be equal, for example? A lot of people end up having a joint account, like kind of for household expenses, but a lot of people want to maintain some separate accounts so that they have some more independence with their money as well.
And even though you are, like you said, even you are a couple, you need that little bit of independence. You need more security, too. So prenuptial agreements, is that something that should also come into the discussion?
Well, they're very helpful. Okay, now it's interesting. There's still a stigma, you know, when it comes to prenuptials. But I think people should at least talk about it. You know, I bring it up in client meetings because they can really set expectations. And even if you don't end up getting one, just talking about it can help set expectations for both parties.
All right. And of course, if you need to have any more information about second marriage planning or just general planning in general, just go to Zarka offers a complete line of those products. Just go to our website, foxaid.com, for a link and click Seen on TV tab right at the top of the page. Alex, always a pleasure. Thanks for joining us this morning.
It was a pleasure. Thank you.
All right.